Facebook promoter or media promoter, whatever skill you have, if you want to donate it at the Wellness Advocates of Detroit, we welcome it, because obviously there are hundreds of thousands of people in the city of Detroit that need what it is that we're trying to give. And we're not saying that we have the only answer, but we're saying that we have an important one, and we need help getting it done.
Okay. And there was a comment from, I think it was on Facebook, when we were talking about you coming on the show. And basically, the individual was saying that no one is addressing academic issues that are plaguing black boys. I know that it's not true that no one is doing it, but is this an area that is severely neglected, more so than with black girls?
Black boys are being raised, for the most part, unfortunately, by women who do all that they can in trying to raise these young boys. And then school teachers are not prepared to deal with the students as both parent and teacher. And they can't supervise the behavior. They can't be a counselor and a probation officer simultaneously. So what you have is young boys are gravitating to what they know what young boys do, which is mischievous. They like to talk a lot. They like to do things that they think is funny, especially the younger guys. This is the best time to go after these guys is when they're in elementary and middle school. Because at that point, they're not totally contaminated. They're not so self-destructive that you can't save them. When people say that no one's dealing with the academic level of young African-American boys, that's false. We have a lot of young boys that are being lost through the pipeline, either in the streets or in the prisons. When I say in the streets, I mean they're deceased. But we also have a lot of schools and educators, who are having success with young boys. Across the country, there are academies for young boys that are doing monumental work. And Chicago has an academy that has graduated three classes of young boys. 100% of them got scholarships to college.
Hakeem Adebooty?
Hakeem School is one, but there's another school. There are several schools in Chicago and across the country that have academies, small academies, dealing with young boys academically. But I think that if we can get academic thinking individuals to consider using group process work with young boys at any level, whether they're incorrigible, if delinquent, you can use group process work if you can manage a group. Behavior can be changed. And this is one of our premises, that behavior can be changed through a group process. When young boys submit to a group process, exponentially their work improves, their aptitude toward respecting who they are in terms of being black and African American in this country. Their sense of consciousness is increased, and their sense of love for themselves and the community increases. And this is because they've been practicing in a group. The group experiences, real life experiences, take children in places where they would never go as an individual.
What do you see as the consequence of media influence with young boys?
Yeah, that's an interesting concept, because the media's concept of malehood or masculinity is defined by the Western concept of what a white man ought to be, honestly. Unfortunately, because we represent the culture of people who are on the outside of the Western culture, being black and African, we unfortunately, from inheritance, identify with the dominant culture. And so we tend to identify with these definitions of what a man ought to be: individualistic, selfish, and violent. Well, we have to put up programs that seek to change the mindset, the behavior, and the spirit of young boys. Groups are the only answer for us. It's the only answer. It's the only way you can get people to change. Now, I'm not saying that every male that you invite to participate in a group at your school or in your community is going to commit to it. But what we're trying to create is a movement where young boys begin to see that participating in a group is better than going to the Navy or the Army. It's better than being a part of a gang. It's better than running the streets and running from the police, particularly in today's climate where the police show no mercy to young boys, particularly young African-American boys. Mm-hmm. So we're trying to give them an option to stay in the community, to grow and develop. And here's the thing that we are...
Be a resource for that community.
Be a resource for that community. Not only leadership mm-hmm. in terms of social, political, and even religious leadership, but we need new entrepreneurs.
That's right. Politically, and economically.
We need to stop having our kids think that a job is the most important thing they could ever have. What they need to know is that we live in a global world, and there's an opportunity to grow and develop within the globe.
That's right. Every last one of our young brothers and sisters need to be introduced or reintroduced to Marcus Moselle Garvey.
That's right.
On a consistent basis. On a consistent basis. Because as they grow, their paradigm will shift and they will view Marcus Moselle Garvey and or the concept of Up You Mighty Race, Accomplish What You Will differently. Because they don't... And then when you go back to the question that the brilliant question the sister asked you about, the influence of media on our young. That's why it's imperative. It's like water and air for us. It's an essential need for our existence, for us to control our image. And the only way that we can do that is through media and the internet, because these are the major components that is used to hypnotize our people, and to demasculine, to take away the masculinity of, I'm going to put it this way. When you look at how a man is perceived or he is portrayed through media and through entertainment, it is testosterone driven and it is misdirected from a male chauvinistic aspect, as if to say that the only way that you can be a man is if you are disrespectful to women, and the only way that you can be a woman is if you dress provocative in the community. Now, many people is not going to agree with that philosophy or my way of thinking, but by me being incarcerated, I don't have anything but time to analyze, dissect what it is that we see on television. And what I see in the predominant shows that we're watching, and they are taking notes themselves because they're watching at the statistics and the ratings of shows or what the shows are getting from Love and Hip Hop, Basketball, Wives, Atlanta Housewives. They look at these particular shows and they see the ratings, they see what they dress in, the clothes that they have on, and all of it is over testosterone driven. It is driven from that aspect, and it is pervertedly driven as well through what the women wear. So if we don't control our image, someone is going to always portray to us the image that they want us to portray. And the images that we're getting has nothing to do with linking yourselves up with the ancient and divine creed of our forefathers that we were stripped away from. Because if we link back up with that, then we're going to be free, or we're going to retain our freedom. Because the only way that we can be free is if we're living in the culture and the principles of ourselves and not the culture and the principles of someone else. So as long as we're living the lifestyle and the principles and the culture of something or someone that does not inherently belong to us, we are a slave. And the best slave to have is a slave that doesn't know he or she is a slave. That was the only reason why it was time for Abraham Lincoln to say, let's free the slaves from chattel slavery, because mentally Jim Crow or mentally Willie Lynch was something that works, and it works even to this day, today. And it is the very reason why the youth and the adults are disconnected, because of that Willie Lynch philosophy. So when we don't have the connection between the youth and the adults, and the youth don't know how to come together outside of smoking some dope, drinking some alcohol, and gangbanging, then you talking about a bunch of slaves that's just walking around that don't know they slaves, and they are doing a better job of killing ourselves or each other than the KKK has ever done to us during Reconstruction, etc.
Yeah.
So we must get back to those principles in which you're talking about, brother, and it is community. That is definitely where the key is at, because we are trapped in this me, I, self idea, when that me, I, self idea is not bringing us back into learning how to circulate the dollars within our community 6 to 8 times before it leaves out of the community. Now you're talking about economical wealth. You're talking about learning how to be social. Then when you have the economical wealth and the social wealth within our community, then we will be respected politically. You know?
Yeah.
So now we have to learn, we have to embed that in our young children from the age of, from the womb to the tomb. The mother has to be giving this to the child while the child is in her stomach. See, school don't start at 5 years old. School starts as soon as that child is, in, that woman is impregnated, then the class is in session. And we have to get back to that. But this is something that has to be taught. And the only way it can be taught is through brothers and sisters like yourself becoming active, and brothers like myself who is in a position to provide the platform from a media aspect to get that message out there to the community. We have to stop being scared and stop compromising our principles for the dollar. Always wanting to say, okay, well, let me mix this love and hip-hop type of flavor, this Atlanta housewife type of flavor into my program so that I can boost my ratings. Stop compromising your principles and turn it off. You don't have to watch it. That's all I have to say with that. I know I have a tendency to just run off at the mouth. I apologize.
Your spirit is healthy. I mean, it's important that we have passion for our people, because we have too many people who have absolutely no passion for us at all. You're absolutely accurate. If we didn't identify totally with the Western world, we wouldn't be in the shape we're in. If we identify more with answers, concrete answers that will move us from this position that we face, we would be in a better position. And I'm looking forward to that conversation with anybody that wants to have it.
Yeah, and I mean, they definitely preparing our young for prison. In school, they're taking the metal detectors in there, they're taking the wands in there, they're putting the police officers in there that is nothing but correctional officers. The same philosophy, you got to write a pass to go here, you got to be shook down to go to this part of the school building, to that part of the school building. The very same thing that's going on in the prison system, the way that we move, where they're going to be counting every, I mean, they're counting bodies to make sure that everyone is there. This is what they do inside the prison system. They put barbed wire fence around the prison system. So now you're being desensitized to prison. So when you go, when they send them to prison, they're not going to feel as if they're out of bounds or they're in an environment that's not of their natural environment. They're going to feel just like they're at home.
Right. They've already been acclimated to the culture.
Exactly. Exactly. So the same way that they're being frisked and shook down before they go into the school building, it's the same way that they're being frisked and shook down before they come inside the prison system, whether you're coming in to visit or you're coming in to become a resident.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to keep that in mind, that this thing is serious. They're kicking our children out of school for minor infractions. They're putting them back into the streets or sending them to the streets where they're not going to do anything but commit a crime, come to prison, and here is where they say, okay, now we'll give you a GED. So that's what they're basically saying to the children. Kick them out. We don't care. Send them out there. They're going to commit a crime. We'll give them a GED in prison. And that's about as far as the education is going to go, unless they pick up books by the Most Honorable Marcus Mozell Garvey, Elijah Muhammad, Prophet Noble Drew Ali, Jay Rogers, Sheikh Abdul Jah, and the list goes on and on. But these particular books are now being STG. They're being security threat grouped out. The very Willie Lynch letter is a security threat to the Michigan Department of Corrections. They will not allow it inside the prison. How can you not allow something that can help you reverse the psychological disenfranchisement that our people are in inside the prison system, where they need to be reeducated? They must understand that they are perpetuating the Willie Lynch syndrome when they're calling themselves Bloods and Crips and Gangster Disciples and such and such this and such and such. As a matter of fact, it goes even further than that. When you say you're in the Nation of Islam, the more science tip love America, I'm a Christian, I'm a Protestant, I'm part of the Pan-African Orthodox Church, and we utilize these organizations to separate ourselves and keep ourselves in our own separate corners, you know, in own separate parts of Detroit, instead of coming together. That's Willie Lynch within the religious system. So if we don't...
You have 1 minute remaining.
If we don't educate ourselves to that syndrome, then we can't wake ourselves up. This is something that is a class that should be taught at the age of 5, a Willie Lynch syndrome class.
Exactly. And those are also ideas and principles that were reinforced through the seasoning process long before the idea of having a Willie Lynch or Willie Lynch letter that actually talks about literally, you know, outlining these things for Southern slave owners in order for them to maintain their assets. You know, there was seasoning. The seasoning process was an actual process that happened that that led to some of these harmful dynamics between within our relationships.
Y'all, get ready to cut me off. I'll talk to you later, Sister Darian. Peace,
yes,
y'all.
Sir.
See y'all next week.
Okay, peace. Thank you. So yeah, that seasoning process, you know, was something that was brought in to impact the way that we relate to each other in all these different types of relationships. So within intimate relationships and relationships with our friends and family and, you know, those who we have differences with. So that kind of brings us back to the focus of your event that's coming up on
October the 11th,
and that's going to be one day after the 10-10-15.
That's right.
That's so
right.
After
that's
you
right.
come back from Washington, D.C., it's
come
time
to the conference.
The conference. And can you give us the name of the conference again?
The name of the conference is a wellness conference for men and women. And also, you should know this, that even though the tickets are $25, which includes a meal, for couples, the cost is
$40. Okay, $40 for couples. And so we'll be looking for that information on your website.
That's correct.
Wellness Advocates of Detroit.
That's right.
And also check us out on Facebook on The Think Tank at facebook.com. And also... you will see us again on Fridays, every Friday from 5 to 6 p.m. on WHPR. And thank you very much for tuning in. Asante Sana.